If you haven't seen the trailer for Michael Bay's new film Songbird, would recommend you watch it. And afterwards, I recommend you take a Xanax and calm down a little bit, because this is not an easy watch. Let me tell you right now, this is an anxiety-inducing trailer, to say the least, especially during a time when, in the United States at least, COVID-19 cases are spiking all over the country. And this is not the type of movie that you want to see, to think even remotely think about where the country is headed in the next couple of years as we continue to battle this horrible virus. Songbird is set to come out next year. I'll talk about that in a little bit. I don't think it's going to, and I have my reasons for believing that. But it's got a stacked cast. It's got KJ Apa, Sophia Carson, Craig Robinson, Bradley Whitford, who we talked about actually last on the bonus show last week about Get Out, Paul Walter Hauser, who I adore from I, Tonya and Defy Bloods and a number of other movies, and even Demi Moore in this thing. But this is going to be the first probably major mainstream pandemic movie. It exists in a world where they're, well, for starters, they're up to COVID-23 now, evidently.
Yeah.
And essentially, it's gotten to the point now where it's economic catastrophe. It looks like a third world country. You know, it's completely decimated. There's even a death counter, billboard, and everything about how many people have died from this ever-mutating respiratory virus. Mm-hmm. But it's to the point now where people, like, it's almost like a state of martial law, for lack of a better
soldiers
term.
Soldiers are in mop gear, like full-on, complete hazmat suits. And like they have military checkpoints to monitor movement throughout the city and like tracking and all that stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. It's absolutely wild. And it's frightening too. And especially like how they take their temperatures and stuff. And then like if you wind up running a fever, it's like there's going to be the National Guard or soldiers at your front door in a matter of minutes. Like, it is intense as hell. And let me just say this. We'll go into talking about this. Leave it to Michael Bay, who was doing so well, at least for his standards, in a string of pretty decent movies like Pain and Gain and even 13 Hours, the Benghazi film with John Krasinski, was on a streak of pretty good movies, and then he does something like this. I mean, to premiere a trailer for a film like this right now feels unbelievably insensitive and misguided. At a time when this pandemic is still going on, people are dying, cases are rising, the economy all over the friggin' globe is in turmoil, and then to premiere a movie like this that plays a pandemic as sort of a disaster scenario for like popcorn movie entertainment, it just feels wrong. And I'm not saying you can never do it. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying in 5 years this wouldn't be an entertaining movie, but it just feels like way too much, way too soon, in a time when, at least for the foreseeable future, shit ain't going back to normal.
Mm-hmm. It's difficult to say the words too soon and not be made fun of for it, because you'd think like, oh, nothing's too soon. That's my kind of humor. But this is just absolutely disgusting. This is profiteering. This is irresponsible in so many ways that I would love to go into. But first, let me just state that I was getting cool with Michael Bay, like, for a good while. Like, as
I was too.
When I was younger, as you said, like, but when I was younger, let me first say that I was like, high art, like Michael Bay is a blight upon the world of cinema, and he only makes the medium worse by putting out these brainless movies. Like, it's cringy. Whatever.
I had that phase.
Yeah,
too.
Everyone does.
We were cool.
And many people still are like that. You know, in some ways, I'm like, but like, dude, whatever. Like, I watched the latest Bad Boys movie, Bad Boys for Life. I was like, this is stupid as hell, but I did watch it and I had a good time. Like, it is what it is. Transformers, stupid as hell, had a good time, whatever. All the Transformers movies, they're just, you know what you're doing. It's like Adam Sandler, right? They're not high art. His Happy Madison movies, right? They're not high art, but you know what you're getting into when you watch this. You need to know better at this point. So if you're going to knock it for not being high art or whatever, or like trying to like actually try, then whatever, dude. At this point, it's your problem. But
it's a you problem.
Exactly. But for Songbird, it's different, man. This is there was an article called, I forget, but it was like trying to say, it was talking about how a lot of creative folks were trying to come out with the first great American coronavirus movie, and Michael Bay was in the front runner for them, and essentially this was the movie that he was being rumored to make, Songbird, in that article. And in that article he said, like, I forget who wrote it, but they mentioned that it just feels really weird how people are doing this, and if you can compare the COVID pandemic with 9/11 and how people are making movies so soon in the midst of that, it's as if you were making a 9/11 movie in between the first and the second towers falling. If that makes sense, right? And it's to me, this movie, it is just preying upon every conceivable fear that we have experienced and will continue to experience probably to greater degree in the coming months. And it's just, what are you doing here? This is not right. This is like you're provoking a greater distrust of science, of government, of a greater distrust, you know, not that all you need to completely obey government, but you know what I mean by that, right? In a world where mm-hmm. we can't even conceptually vote correctly because people think that they need to store. This is literally happening today as we're recording this. Like, people need to storm polling places in Michigan because, the votes aren't being counted right. You need to go there and make sure it's being counted right. Like, what the hell does that mean, right? But like, this is just so reckless and dangerous. And I know I sound like a 1984, not, that was very specific, but a 1989, conservative Republican saying, like, this film will make, this satanic metal music will make the children have the sex more or whatever, right? It really sounds like I'm saying that. But we have fully demonstrated here in 2020 that people are dumb, right? People will believe Facebook posts and, like, at face value and think that politicians are drinking the blood of infants in a pedophile ring or whatever, and you put this out knowing full that people will eat this up and potentially do bad things with it is honestly just really irresponsible. Let me be clear, I am not saying that the government should come in here and ban the movie. I'm not saying that the movie should be shut down or whatever. I'm not saying that it should, there should be, because if anything, that would just make things worse. But I will personally say that you don't need to watch this movie. It's good. There's no tangible benefit to be watching this right now at this time. Maybe in 3 years, maybe in the real 2023, when, things have cooled down, hopefully. That's fine. That's whatever, because it's a dumb Michael Bay movie. But here in the now, this is like a new level of wrong from Michael Bay. This is like morally wrong. Legally, it's whatever. I'm not saying he should be prosecuted, but
from a moral standpoint, I totally understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
I'm not confident we're going to see it in 2020 either. And I think what's going to wind up happening, because this movie's already gotten ferocious backlash, I think what's going to wind up happening is they're going to have to table this thing.
Yeah.
And I mean, at least for a little bit, at least until there's a vaccine that most, if not a good majority of the country has taken, or a good majority of the world for just greater significance too. I think they're going to have to wait for that. Because at the end of the day, let's say, okay, let's take the optimistic route. Let's say we get a vaccine by early 2022, 2021. It's mostly effective. Theaters reopen by the springtime, like April, May, okay? Let's say that. That's the best case scenario, all right, as far as I'm concerned. Let's say Songbird comes out in July. I can't imagine this movie doing very well to begin with, because even with the Michael Bay stamp of approval and the Michael Bay name, it's just one of those movies kind of like 99 Homes, which is one of my favorite films of the last decade. But 99 Homes was about the housing crisis and a working poor family getting evicted from their home and the son of that family going and working for the man who evicted him. I think it's a phenomenal movie with a lot of social commentary, but it bombed in theaters. Of course it did, because most people saw that and lived through it. They didn't need to see it dramatized on the screen for them, and I totally understand that. It's kind of like this. Let's say this movie comes out next summer. We're still going to be, it's kind of weird to say, but we're kind of going to get reacclimated to doing things again. You think people want to sit in the dark 2.5 hours and watch a movie about people being locked down in cities? We just lived through this shit. You know, we just lived through this and it wasn't enjoyable then. And I'm not really taking any pride in getting my anxiety levels raised watching this movie about people who are like, who are communicating through doors. You know what I mean? With the guy from, with the kid from Riverdale, you know?
No, he gives me weird vibes, but at least with like World Trade Center, right? Which covered 9/11 5 years after the fact. At least in that film, you know, people were worried like, is this too soon, or like, is this like, do people really want to watch this? At the very least, that movie, which I did like, at least that movie, you know, celebrates at the end, celebrates the first responders, celebrates the perseverance of, you know, the hero spirit or whatever. It celebrates things. What the hell is Songbird gonna do, right? What is that gonna celebrate? Absolutely nothing. It's a horror, it's like a pseudo horror film. That like, you know,
with thriller. Romeo and Juliet style, like kind of narrative there.
If anything, it's encouraging people to break lockdown, to break quarantine and be like, nah, I have not seen the film. Maybe the film turns around and lambasts that. Maybe this film is completely in lockstep with CDC guidelines or whatever, and that's the true message. I don't know, it hasn't come out yet, but knowing Michael Bay and like the movies he makes and knowing just what that trailer was outputting, I am very skeptical that that is the message that this movie will portray. It grosses me out, and it's so perplexing that someone can conscionably do this. Look at the world and consciously do this. Does Michael Bay really think that he's like, I'm making the film of our times, and this will be so cathartic for all of us?
I should mention before we sign off here, I should mention this too. The movie is directed by Adam Mason, for full disclosure.
Okay.
And so Michael Bay, but here's the thing. Michael Bay is the executive producer, and it's being distributed. It is planning to be distributed through Platinum Dunes, which is his company. So his name and fingerprints are all over this thing. But I know and this is the thing I had to remind myself back in high school when I was like ardently against Michael Bay, is that Michael Bay ultimately, he's not a writer. He's not a writer.
Not at all.
He's not a writer. He's not a writer, and he's not always a director either.
Yeah.
But so in this case, he isn't. But his fingerprints are all over this movie.
I genuinely forgot that he wasn't directing this for a hot minute.
Yeah, Adam Mason. I should have said it probably at the beginning.
That's
Adam
fine.
Mason is the director. I don't find much of a biography on him. But no, Michael Bay absolutely had a hand in this thing, you know, completely. His fingerprints, again, are all over it. And he probably had input. I mean, even the way that this movie looked like it was shot, it kind of reminded me like how I always thought of like, you know, the movie Super 8.
Yeah.
Where like everybody thinks that's a Spielberg movie. It's a J.J. Abrams movie.
Abrams.
And this is Star Wars. Well, Abrams directed it. Spielberg was a producer.
That
but
makes
it
perfect
felt
sense.
Like Spielberg. Like you could tell though that like Spielberg
I didn't know
was
that,
like
actually.
In Abrams' ear. You could tell Spielberg was in Abrams' ear throughout that movie, like, do it this way, do it this way. I feel like Michael Bay was kind of backseat director on this thing, judging from the
probably.
Trailer. You know, like, probably backseat director. So, I mean, he can't be absolved from this at all. But, I mean, for what it's worth, he's not the writer or director of the thing.
Last thing I'll say on this is that if you really want to, in the middle of the lockdown, if you really want to watch something that is horrifying and you really want to, like, live through, like, watch something played out to its max extent while in that same situation, okay, fine, go watch Contagion. Seriously, I'm
100%,
not watch Contagion. It's more realistic. It's not even like to a ridiculous, not that it has to be realistic, but like it's not like some sort of dumb cliche horror thing. Two, it's a whole experience in and of itself. The performances are fantastic, and this is to me Steven Soderbergh's finest work out of anything he's done, and I love the Ocean's movies. And three, at least in that movie, like there's a vaccine and like it's distributed properly. So there's like a happy ending. So it'll make you feel better by the end of it too. I should also mention there's even like Jude Law's character is that misinformation person who's profiteering off of it. And at least he gets his comeuppance in the end. So yeah, watch Contagion. Don't watch this dumbass thing.
Yeah. Ugh. Yeah, and point four or point five, I would take Steven Soderbergh 8 days a week over Michael Bay, just saying.